ओके, लेट्स सी, हियर इज़ एन एग्जाम्पल और प्रोग्राम हाउ टू डू और हाउ टू यूज अ डिक्शनरी ओवर देयर. वी हैव टू क्रिएट दिस डिक्शनरी एज ओड नेम. इट विल हैव ओड नंबर्स हियर 1 and 9, वेयर द की इज़ अ डेसिमल नंबर एंड द वैल्यू इज़ द कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग नंबर्स इन वर्ड्स. यू हैव टू जस्ट राइट द वर्ड्स ओवर देयर एंड दीज ऑपरेशन यू हैव टू परफॉर्म ओवर इट. सो हाउ टू डू इट, लेट्स स्टार्ट हियर. डिस्प्ले द कीज. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू जस्ट क्रिएट वन डिक्शनरी ओवर देयर. सो वी आर क्रिएटिंग हेयर ओड नेम डिक्शनरी हेयर. कर्ली ब्रेसेस विल बी स्टार्ट हेयर. वन इज अ की. हेयर वी आर राइटिंग हेयर वन इन टर्म्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग, दैट इज वर्ड्स. नाउ द थ्री, नाउ इट्स वर्ड्स. हेयर वी आर गेटिंग हेयर स्ट्रिंग टाइप वैल्यू फॉर दिस की. हेयर सेम लाइक एस वी हैव टू जस्ट राइट फॉर 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. दे आर फाइव एलिमेंट्स ओवर देयर. सो इफ वी print here odd, so all these elements would be printed here. Now the first one is display the key. So for displaying the key, you have to just write here odd dot keys. The function name is keys, so we are passing here. So if we write here odd dot keys, so dict keys are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. Keys would be displayed over there. Now the next one is display the values. Display the values here. So here is the function odd dot values. So all these values 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 in string type, it would be represented over there. Now the next one is display the items. C part, display the items. So here is again the same function we are using here, odd dot items. So items will get all these key value pair here, 1 and 4. This one key, one text value would be represented here, same like for all these elements over there. Now the next one is find the length of dictionary. So how can we use it? We have to just simply write here len, and these parentheses will have argument as dictionary name, that is odd. So it will give you 5 because there are 5 elements over there. Now the next one is if e part. Here we have to check if 7 is present or not. So for existence of any element in the dictionary, so we have to just use a membership operator, that is in operator. So we have to just write down here 7 in odd. So 7 is present in the dictionary as key, so answer would be true, would be returning as boolean value. Now the next one is check if 2 is present or not. So here we have to just check it. In odd, 2 in odd here. Now the next one is its answer is false because in operator we are using here for existence, but 2 is not existed in the dictionary over there. So its answer would be false, return as boolean value. So our output would be false. Now the next one is retrieving the value corresponding to the key 9. So if we want to get the value over there, so if we want to get all these values, so we can use here values function. See, if we want to get the all keys, so we can use here keys function. And if we want to get the specific value regarding any key, so we can use here get function. So as we are using here get function, so how can we use it? We have to just use here dictionary name odd dot get, and then we are passing here 9 as a key. So its corresponding value would be represented here as 9. So these are the functions which we apply over there in terms of programming. And the next one is delete the item from the dictionary corresponding to the key 9. So item will include key value pair both. So how can we delete it? So for deletion we have delete statement over there. So how we use it, let's see the example. Del statement we are using here, del dictionary name, and the indexing we have to just pass the key to which we have to just delete the items over there. So there is 9 we are passing. So if it doesn't return any value, just simply delete it, those values here. Now if we print here odd dictionary here, so it would be represented only the 1, 3, 5 and 7, 9. That means the fifth element, 9 as a key and 9 text as a value would be deleted from there. Now the next one is Let's see the example. Here is another program. Write a program to enter names of employees and their salaries as input and store them in dictionary. We have to just pass here names of employees and their salaries as input at the time of execution, and then we have to store it in terms of dictionary over there. So how can we do it? Let's see. First we have to take here num. Here is integer function we are using. Input, enter the number of employees whose data to be stored, that means how many number of employees we are getting here. So let's see the output. Simultaneously enter the number of employees to be sorted. Let's suppose we have entered here 5. So for 5 employees we have to enter the data. Now count is equal to 1. Now employee is equal to dict, a function we are using here. So we are creating here empty dictionary over there. So we are using just the inbuilt function dict one, dict function here. So employee is the empty dictionary we are creating here. Just only we have to opt here another method also, like as employee equal to curly braces, we have to just use it, or otherwise we can use here dict function also, same. Now while count less than equal to num, that means number we have passed is 5 and count's value is 1. So while 1 is less than equal to 5, that means the number of employees are 1 to 5. So the loop will be going on from 1 to 5 here. Name, we are getting the name here. Input, enter the name of employee. So enter the name of employee would be returning here. From the keyboard we have just enter here Tarun. So Tarun would be saved in name variable over there. Same like as salary we are getting here, integer type of salary we are getting here, enter the salary, and then 12,000 suppose we are giving from our keyboard, so 12,000 will be stored in salary. Now employees of name, that means employee is a dictionary name, its key is name and its value is salary. So here the first element would take like as Tarun and its salary is 12,000 would be stored. Now count is equal to count plus 1. This time count value is 2. It will go again for the while loop, checking for the condition, and same aapki statements would be represented here or executed here. Now at last when count's value would be 6, now it would be come out from the loop. Now at last it will print here employee name, all these five inputs we are just generating here from the user. Now at last print employee name, then salary, then employee name and salary. This would be represented like as slash t we are using for the tab. So here is a one tab we are giving here. Now for loop we are taking here because we have 5 elements here, so one by one we have to just print from the dictionary. So for loop we are using 4k in employee is the dictionary name. So first of all, first element would be come in k. So here is print k, that means k is the key and key's name is named Tarun. Now double t, that means double tab we are giving here. Now again employee of key, that means value of k, that means value of Tarun, that was 12,000 as a salary would be represented, and all these 5 outputs would be there as per we are passing all this name and salary as key value pair. This is the key and this is the value. So key value pair would be represented like as name and salary. So in this way we have to just represent these names and regarding all these keys. So I hope it's clear to you, and this chapter now is completed.